My name is Nabawangula Barbara. From Kawempe.
I've
come here to testify to Jesus. I came here with three problems. The first problem was bedwetting for 42
years.
This problem was not on a daily basis. But each time a blessing was coming my way, that I get joy in my life, I would bedwet, and that would be the end of everything. I started realizing this problem, and it caused me so much hurt. It caused me so much hurt when I was about to sit for my primary living examinations. I was very clever. But when time came for us to do the exams, about 3 days to the exam, I bedwetted. When we sat for the exams, on bringing the results, at least I should have passed in Super B. But I passed in grade 3. I felt sorrow. I was so hurt. They wanted me to repeat the class. But my mother fought against it. I got a school. When I joined secondary school, things became even worse. This problem would reoccur. Every time I would see that now I've started understanding what they are teaching in class, I would bedwet. I'd get confused and I would get fed up of school. Then I would go back home. I troubled my mother so much in secondary school. When time came for senior 4 exams, there's a subject I was so sure of, and I wanted to become a nurse. That was the subject for health science. When we're about to do that exam for health science, about 2 days to the exam, I bedwetted.
But why in the examination room?
When we entered the examination room, I did that exam thinking I've done something good. But when we went out of the examination hall, like students normally do, we started going through our answers that we had put on the paper. But brethren, I realized that I had failed. I cried. I lost all courage. And on bringing back the results, I hadn't passed. Those who were studying behind me in the classes before me, those who are doing worse than me in academics, passed and they were admitted to Nsambya Nursing School.
Mama wange yalwana.
My mother struggled hard
nantwala ku stenography course.
And took me for a stenography course.
Eno nawulirira ekintu kino kyeyongera okujanga mu mwezi wakire mirundi esatu.
And this time, this problem of bedwetting would occur like 3 times in a month. And in the second year when we were about to do our final exams, I got fed up of school. I got money.
Typewriting.
I gave it to the teacher who was teaching us typewriting. I told him, I beg you, draft for me a certificate, I'm tired of staying here. So I left the school. The suffering with bed waiting didn't stop here. I got the first husband. We agreed that he marries me. He told his family. His family came and matched up with our family. We planned for introduction ceremony. And while we were in the process preparing for the introduction ceremony, I bedwetted. The gentleman who was supposed to marry me came. He called me kindly and gently and said, Barbara, should I tell you? I will not manage to marry you. I've been scared that your mother is so tough. I felt so bad.
Nemberao.
I stayed.
Waite chisera chitono.
After a short time.
Nefuno mwami owokubiri.
I got another man, a second one.
Ono mwami owokubiri.
And this second man.
Ebintu yabitwala mubukwesfu nyo.
Did things in a hiding way.
Wali wabule nakubiri nga ayagala okukyala ewaffe.
2 days before the planned visit that he wanted to come and visit my parents.
Oyangambira nti genda ogambe tata nti njagala kukyala.
When he told me that go and tell your father that I want to come and pay him a visit.
Yagiye kana akyala.
He came home and paid a visit.
Tutegeeragana ne bazadde bange ebyokwanjula.
And they reached an agreement on the bride price he was to pay.
Olunaku olwo lwe nakoma okulaba ku mwami oyo.
That was the last day I saw that gentleman.
Kubanga olwavu okukyala.
Because soon after the visitation.
Bwe naddayo eka nafuka ku buliri.
When I went back home, I bedwetted.
Saddayo okumulabako.
I never saw that man again.
Olebya basajja ne bintama.
Now I got fed up of issues of men.
Ngamba kantandika okukola.
I said let me start working.
Nayina omukisa gw'okukola.
I had the blessing of working.
N'abaali bamanyi nti ndi muwala mukozi.
And those who knew that I'm a hard working girl.
Bampanga emirimu nkole.
Would give me jobs to work.
Naye bwe nakolanga ew'omuntu omwezi nga guli kumpi okugwako.
But if I would work at someone's place and it's about to end a month.
Nsobole okufuna omusaala gwange.
So that I can earn my salary.
Nemfuka.
I would bedwet.
Olo mukama wange nga yekwasa.
Then my boss would get an excuse.
Eranga tansasula.
And he wouldn't pay me.
Ekizibu ekyo kyamalako emyaka 42.
I had this problem of bedwetting for 42 years.
Sakomawo nefuna business eyange.
I didn't stop there, I got my own business.
Natandika okuyamba bazadde bange.
I started helping my parents.
Kubanga nze muwala omukulu ewaffe.
Because I'm the eldest daughter in the home.
Naye bwe nali ntuuka. Kumuntu nga wokulakulanira.
But when I'd reach a stage of prosperity.
N'okweyagala ennyo.
And feeling so happy.
Okusobola okuzimba.
To be able to build a house.
Nenfuka.
I would bedwet.
Bwakeera kumakya nga ngenze kudduka. Ne bangoba.
When I went to the shop, I was fired.
Ebintu nga sina wakubiteeka.
When I went to the shop, I was chased away. I had nowhere to put my goods. The goods were just shared out by people. All the ladies I left at that job at the shop where I was working. Their plots of land are in
Machindye.
And they built the houses in Machindye. Satan didn't stop at torturing me with bedwetting.
Abantu bayongera okumpita Barbara jangu tukole.
People continued calling me, Barbara, come let's work.
Naye omuntu bwe yansuubiza nga nti nja kuwa ssente oba ku lwokutaano.
But if someone would promise like I'll give you money on Friday.
Kati olwaleero lwa Sunday.
Say today is Sunday.
Bwe lutuuka olwokusatu nga daladala sure deal.
If it would come to Wednesday and it's a sure deal.
Nga nfuka.
I would bedwet.
Olwo omuntu akubulako.
And then the person who promised would disappear.
Oba toddamu kumulaba
kale. I would never see that person again.
Oba omuntu bw'awaliriza n'akuwa ssente okuyamba.
And if someone forcefully somehow persisted and gave me the money to help me.
Ku mulimu oba mugoba.
That person would be fired from the job.
Oba afuna accident.
If not, he or she would get an accident.
Baganda bange nabonabona n'ekizibu kino.
Brethren, I suffered with this problem.
Ekizibu ekyokubiri.
The second problem.
Muzimu gwa bwenzi.
Is the spirit of fornication.
When I lemererwa okufumbirwa.
When I failed to get married.
Nentandika okwendanga ku basajja abafumbo.
I started fornicating with married men.
Era nenfuna omuzimu ogw'okwakirira.
And I got a spirit of lust.
Ogona gumaramu emyaka 3.
I had it for 30 years.
Ekizibu ekyokusatu.
The third problem.
Gwali muzimu gwa butamivu.
Was the spirit of drunkenness.
Ngenda okutandika okutegeera bwenti.
By the time I started understanding.
Nga mama wange atunda mwenge.
My mother was selling alcohol.
Enanga business etubezaawo.
And the business that was our source of livelihood.
Wali kutunda mwenge.
Was selling alcohol.
Era omwenge gwe gwamperera.
And from alcohol, that's where my school fees was got.
Nze bwe nabanga sinywedde mwenge.
If I would not drink alcohol.
Nga sebaka.
I could not sleep.
Naye nga ndi mu mbeera eyo ey'okubonaabona.
But in such a situation of suffering.
Nayina edduuka e Kazo.
I had a shop in Kazo.
Bampa capital nga dduuka likola bulungi.
I was given capital and the shop was working very well.
Edduuka ne litandika okugwawo.
The shop started collapsing.
Nengende wa mukwano gwange yali mutunzi wa mwenge.
I went to my friend who was selling alcohol.
Olwo bwe natuuka ewuwe nasanga takyagutunda.
When I reached at her home, I found she was no longer selling it.
Muyitiremu ku bizibu byange.
I'd gone to explain my problems to her.
Nangamba Barbara nze omwenge nakuvaako nalokoka.
She said, Barbara, I stopped this issue of alcohol. I got saved.
Naye ku bizibu byo byemmanyi.
But of the problems that I know that you have.
Genda kubire wa Nabbi Kakande akusabire.
Go to 2 miles, Kubiri, at Professor Mokakande's church to pray for you.
Nagenda yero akubiri.
I went there on Tuesday.
Kurokuna nengera kumacha nenzijawan.
And then Thursday morning, I came here to church.
Mwenaja wanomsaja wakatonda nabi Samuel Kakande yansaviri.
When I came here, the man of God, Prophet Samuel Kakande, prayed for me.
Healing is going on for these people in the mighty name of Jesus. They are receiving a divine solution. A divine healing. A touch of God's power for their deliverance. All in Jesus' name.
Banange nabi Samuel Kakande yansavira.
Brethren, Prophet Samuel Kakande prayed for me. That was the end of the bed wetting. I didn't bed wet again. Father, to confirm this, there are people I deal with in big offices. Now they have peace. When we have deals together, they get money and they have joy. There are some in businesses and we have financial deals together. They have no problem at all. And me too, my work is now moving well. I didn't fornicate again. I didn't have the spirit of lust again. I didn't drink alcohol again. I sleep peacefully. Even if I sleep at 6 p.m.,
I wake up.
I can sleep through the night, except if I chose to wake up in the night to pray. That problem of bed wetting made me hate my mother so much. And I said, why didn't she attend to me? Why didn't she struggle to see that I get a solution? But I'm here before Jesus. I forgive my mother. And I pray for her to have eternal peace. I thank the man of God, Prophet Kakande. Thank you, Father, for praying for me. Thank you for standing there for me. I thank Jesus so much for forgiving me. For setting me free and giving me joy in life. Glory and honor back to Jesus. Clap for Jesus.
Yes, I'm going to go to the hospital.